गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद आवर सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ आवर चैप्टर मोशन. बट बिफोर दैट लेट अस रिकॉल व्हाई ऑसिलेटरी मोशन इज नोन एज वाइब्रेटरी मोशन. ऑसिलेटरी मोशन इज नोन एज वाइब्रेटरी मोशन बिकॉज मूवमेंट ऑफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज टू एंड फ्रो फ्रॉम इट्स पोजिशन ऑफ रेस्ट. So that is the main reason oscillatory motion is known as vibratory motion. Dear children, you have seen some objects keep on repeating their motion. For example, moon keeps on revolving around the earth, completing every revolution 27 days. So here comes a new term, periodicity. What is periodicity? It means repetition after regular intervals of time. And on the basis of this periodicity, motion is divided into two parts, periodic motion and non-periodic motion. What do you mean by periodic motion? If an object repeats its motion in regular interval of time, then it is known as periodic motion. For example, pulse rate of an average human being is periodic. Heartbeat of an average person is also periodic. Now, let us discuss about non-periodic motion. What do you mean by non-periodic motion? It means that if an object does not repeat its motion in regular interval of time, then its motion is called non-periodic motion. For this, I want to give you one example. Just listen. Suppose your friend takes round of a park in 30 minutes. After taking round, he gets tired and sits on a bench and takes some rest. After taking rest, he takes second round of park in 45 minutes. So this motion is what? This is non-periodic motion. Now come to our next topic. Now let me tell you about one more motion, that is mixed motion. What do you mean by mixed motion? It means if an object is having two motions all together, then it is known as mixed motion. For example, a wheel of moving train have translatory as well as rotatory motion. Translatory motion is due to the fact that the train is moving in a straight path, and rotatory motion is due to that the wheels of the train, they are possessing rotatory motion. Now come to our topic, average speed. What do you mean by average speed? Average speed is defined as speed of an object is given by total distance traveled by object divided by total time taken to cover the total distance. So here is the formula, average speed equals to total distance covered divided by total time taken, and its unit is meter per second or kilometer per hour. Now come to our next topic, uniform and non-uniform motion. For this, let me explain you why we are having these two motions. We know in case of motion, time, duration as well as distance traveled are important. If our motion is fast, then more distance is covered in less time. If motion is slow, then less distance is covered in more time. Fast and slow moving objects can be found by knowing speed of the object. Taking distance and time, motion of the object is classified into two types, that is uniform motion and non-uniform motion. Now, what is uniform motion? Uniform motion means that if an object covers equal distances in equal durations of time, then its motion is known as uniform motion. For example, hands of clock. Now, what do you mean by non-uniform motion? Non-uniform motion, it means if an object does not cover equal distances in equal intervals of time, then it is said to have non-uniform motion. For example, suppose you are going to school on bicycle and there is heavy traffic on the way. So you apply the brakes, and if you observe the distance covered every 10 minutes of time, you will find that they are not equal. Thus, motion of the bicycle is non-uniform motion. Now come to next topic, that is weight. What do you mean by weight? It is defined as measure of the pull of earth with which it attracts an object towards its center. It is measured with the help of a spring balance, and weight of an object is given by this relation W equals to mg. What is m? M stands for mass of object in kg, g stands for acceleration due to gravity, and value of g is 10 newton per kg. Now unit of the weight is newton, and its symbol of newton is n. Now other unit of weight is kilogram force, or we can say like kgf. 1 kgf equals to 10 newton. Here comes very important question. How mass is different from weight? Mass is defined as quantity of matter in an object, whereas weight is the force acting on an object due to gravitational pull of earth. Mass of an object is never zero, but weight of an object can be zero. I want to tell you the conditions where weight is zero. Weight of the body is zero in space. So weight of body is zero in a spacecraft orbiting in space. Weight of body is zero at center of Earth, because acceleration due to gravity is zero at center of Earth. Moreover, it has been said, if you buy a gold at equator and sell at pole, because gold of same mass weighs more at pole than at equator. And the last point is this, that the weight of the body is different at equator and poles of Earth due to change in the value of acceleration due to gravity. Now, come to our numerical portion, which is generally asked in the paper. Find the average speed of car. Now you can see the here, this box in which I have written homeland to dreamland 50 km. Time is 1 hour. And when we are going from dreamland to fairyland, distance is 100 km. And time is 2 hours. What is the formula of average speed? Total distance covered over total time taken. So we are going to add both the distances, that is 50 plus 100 equals 150 km, and the time is 1 hour as well as 2 hours. So 1 plus 2 equals to 3 hours, and we are going to get the answer 50 km per hour. Now here comes one more numerical. If a body weighs 20 newton, find its mass. Then for here we are going to use that formula W equals to mg. W is given 20 newtons, g is 10 newton per kg, and here we have to find the mass. By substituting the values, we get mass equals to 20 divided by 10 equals to 2 kg. With this, our chapter finishes.